Thank you. Good evening, and thank you so much for joining us tonight for our Tuesday Live Stan's Pick special, where we're going to celebrate the photographic artistry of our friend and generous Tuesday Live contributor, Brian Stan McRae. And I should point out right off the top that Brian doesn't work alone. He works with his partner, Susie, who does a lot of spotting for him, and they travel around through the woods and wilds of Eastern Ontario and find all sorts of amazing images that they share with us every Tuesday. Certainly, Stan focuses a lot on nature photos, but also images of people and places around Eastern Ontario, like Upper Canada Village. And we have a nice little segment tonight from Upper Canada Village, which is a recreation of an early pioneer village along the shores of the St. Lawrence River in Eastern Ontario. And of course, the mighty St. Lawrence River itself figures well in many of Stan's photo essays, including some pictures of ships. We have some of that tonight as well. I've had a lot of fun over the last few years adding music to Stan's Pics, and sometimes I perform music that's related to the show themes, but more often inspired by Stan's images themselves. And of course, there was that time when Uncle Creepy was hosting the Halloween special, and he thought that Stan's Pics was some sort of illustrated manual. Boy, this gives me the creeps thinking about it. But anyways, without further ado, let's move right ahead to the very first Stan's Pics feature, which was Stan's Owls from episode 13, June 9th, 2020. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the view of the world through Stan's lens.
Thank you. Legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Get You Going. The lake, it is said, never gives up or dead when the skies on November turn gloomy. A load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. The good ship and crew was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with the crew and good captain well seasoned, including some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. Later that night when the ship's bell rang, could it be the northern wind they'd been feeling? Tattletale sound, and the wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late, and the breakfast had to wait when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. Supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed ya." 7 p.m. a main hatchway caved in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know ya." Water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. Later that night, when its lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? Searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 50 more miles behind her. Might have split up, or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. But all that remains is the faces and names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls, Superior sings in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams, the islands and bays offer sportsmen. Further below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November, remember. In a musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. Church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. Legend lives on from the Chippewa on down up the big lake they call Gitchagumi. Superior, they say, never gives up or dead when the gales of November come early.
Thank you.
Babariba. Hey, Babariba. Hey, Babariba. Hey, Babariba. E-I-E-I-E-I-O. E-I-E-I-O. Hey, Babariba. Hey, Babariba. Hey, Babariba. Hey, Babariba. Now, I'm not sure your song how they do that there, but go E-I-E-I-E-I-O, and then you go E-I-E-I-O and answer it, okay? Thank you.
bird doesn't look very edible, but I might eat that one. I like red birds. There might be a little spicy. Oh, that one looks scary. That one's kind of tiny. Maybe an appetizer. Oh, that one looks, could be a little spicy. Oh, I could eat one of those. Oh, is that a turkey? I like turkey, not just at Thanksgiving. Oh, another meaty one. I could have one of those. That's a blue one. I think they might be poisonous. That one's kind of cute. I think I might keep it as a pet. Oh, a rabbit. Awesome pfeffer.
Hasn't that been a fun trip through memory lane, looking at some of those great nature images that Stan's provided to the show over the early part of the early episodes of Tuesday Live, and we certainly have a lot more content that we'll share with you in the future as well. It was so much fun making music along with Stan's Pics, and thank you, Stan, so much for taking the time to share those with us every week, and Susie for helping Stan collect all those images, and everybody out there watching who watches the show or supports us as a subscriber or donates to our virtual tip jar. We certainly appreciate your support as well. And we appreciate everybody who shares the show on Facebook or likes, comments, and just being part of the audience out there tonight. It's always fun having folks out there. It makes it worthwhile for folks like myself and Stan who contributes to the show. We appreciate everything you do. There's a virtual after party on Zoom if you want to join in. I'm not going to be there tonight, but pop in if you want to say hello. I'm not sure who will be there, but maybe be a bit of a discussion there. And if you're watching for the first time, make sure to join our Tuesday Live community at tuesdaylive.ca. And next week, we're going to do a slightly delayed 420 special. So make sure you stick around for that. And until then, let's just take it home with maybe one last segment of Stan's picks. Thanks for watching so much, and we'll see you next week.